Hey everyone, welcome back. Let's go over the process on how to create a character for a video game. First and foremost, understand that there are different methods to this process. Now, the first part usually starts with storyboarding, and this is where the overall theme of the video game is discussed and defined. At this point, it moves over to concept art. Here's where the ideas of the characters are brought to life, and the main goal is to convey a visual representation of the design idea. Rough sketches of major characters are drawn and redrawn until they are fine-tuned to exactly how they should be displayed in the video game. And it's very important to refine the characters as much as possible during the concept phase, because it'll be expensive to make changes later. Next step would be to make a base mesh of the character. The base mesh is essentially a low-res, uncompleted model of the character. During this process, the base mesh is created with all quads if possible to avoid five edges running into each other called poles. If these are present, it could cause pinching in the model when sculpting. When that's finished, many artists will take a moment to UV map the character so that the major areas of the model are already mapped out before the sculpting process. This can drastically save time later when texturing. Now the difference here is that another way is to overlook the UV mapping until the sculpting is completed. This depends on the artist and also potentially the base mesh. Sometimes when creating a character, the base mesh does not have appropriate topology for the animation and will require retopologizing and consequently UV mapping. Once completed, the following phase is the high-resolution sculpt of the model. Sculpting is the process of creating a high-res 3D model with a series of paint strokes using a 3D sculpting software. Later, the details of the model is baked to create a normal map to be used on a low-res model within the game. Here's where things can differentiate in the process. If the model has good edge flow and UV mapping before the sculpting phase, then usually this step is skipped because it's already done. Otherwise, after sculpting, retopologizing would be necessary for the model. This consists of double checking and making sure that the edge flow is right for animating down the road, and then UV mapping the character. After which is texturing the character, the process of creating 2D images to be used for 3D models. Texturing utilizes a UV map to coordinate the model to the flat image in conjunction with shaders and materials to produce the final render. Now, there are multiple ways to create a texture, however, the most common would be to paint right onto the model itself with programs such as Mudbox or ZBrush, or use Photoshop to create 2D images. Now, just a side note, most engines require the dimensions of the image to be in a power of 2, so 2, 4, 8, 16, upwards to 256, 1024, and so on. But 1024 and 2048 are usually sufficient. You probably will not code beyond that for a video game at this time. After all that is done, the final step would be to rig the character. This can also be called skinning. It's the process of weighting a polygon mesh to a skeleton for animation. Once completed, you can send it off to the animator. Woohoo! This is the complete, but not only, process for creating a video game character. Thank you guys very much for watching. Hopefully this helped you guys out there, and have a wonderful day.